What the fuck is up? Ladies and gentlemen, everything in between. Welcome back to the Short Question.
It is currently 6:01 p.m. on the 11th of December. And just got home from work, so it's been a long day. And with episode 64 of the Anatomy Crosscast now available for you guys to stream on Spotify, I decided it was time, kind of late in the process, to go ahead and record a front-to-back session for Curb Stomp the Predators, The Father. And it's funny because this is one of the only albums that I've done two different Under the Skin sessions for, kind of, simply because we recorded... The first time we recorded it wrong. I ended up editing it together. And please let me know, everybody, if the episode 64 upload for Spotify, if like halfway or maybe even three, like a little after halfway through, just everything stops making sense. Please let me know. That way I can go ahead and edit. But with that in mind, if you would be so kind as to consider and subscribing to the Crash Core Patreon, $3 a month to support what will be 5 different channels. Follow all of our playlists on Spotify, including Asahi and Omichi, Path to the Rising Sun. We got a new playlist that I decided to compile recently because the Tennessee scene is just, it's just popping off, bro. We have bands like Whitechapel. We have bands like Divisive, Visitant, and we will be adding plenty more as time goes on, but Orthodox is definitely going to be one of those. We got Ignite the Church for all things black and deathcore / death metal. We have Horror Show, which is for all of our spooky nu metal. We have, then finally, TAC's Greatest Hits with the latest episode hosting Curb Stomp the Predator. So I will be updating this. I will be adding a new song here pretty soon. But it will happen when it happens, okay? Finally, we have here my Depop shop. There's been a fat minute since anybody has grabbed anything or anybody. Like, I've had a couple people like items on the shop, but, like, nothing more. So go ahead and help me clean out my closet. That way, you know, things could be cool again or something. I don't know. Thank you for your time so far, and let's dig into The Father. Keep in mind, y'all, this is a 5-year-old album with 11 songs, but I'm excited. Let's do it.
Let's go.
I'll be right back. I wanted to make sure to go do laundry and get some snacks. Let's go.
Yeah. She was your own. Yeah, he's all wrong.
I was the one to tell her.
attack. Business, what you call business? You say you listen to every word, but do you really? Freedom, 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 freedom suck on your face. When you realize your son wants to meet you face to face.
Get Your eyes are wide open, your bits of answer.
just kill your iron. Blackout! What will be the last thing you remember? Blackout! Tell me, what will be the last thing you feel?
Got two more. This one is lengthy.
That's what you do with your spare time.
Take it all, you little girl. You good little horse.
You've kept photos of those you have victimized. Can you see the pain you have brought them? You have torn apart their lives. You have used your body as an instrument of abuse. Now I give you the chance to decide what is more important. Your eyes, which have led you blindly astray. Or your body.
What's the worst thing? Welcome to your girl. You can come to more of your business for that world. So confused and let me to emerge. As I tell you, I will still have your heart.
Oh. The Punisher.
All right, y'all. So that was officially one of the longest front-to-back sessions that we've done in quite a long time. This time for Curb Stomp the Predator and their 2018 album, Josh's 2018 album, The Father. If you check out the Anatomy Crosscast episode 64, you will be provided all the context that you could ever need regarding the lyrical contents. And goddamn, are the lyrical contents dark? They are melancholy, but they are meant to provide limelight from the perspective of someone like Josh. And it is insane to think that I've personally known people very much like Josh in my life who were, well, provided the origin story that they were. So I will give the lyrical contents of The Father a 10 out of 10. Vocally speaking, I can definitely understand where Josh was coming from when he said, and I quote, "The origin and other tracks on The Father are meant to have a hate era, thy art is murder vibe to them." I can definitely hear it. I love to hear it. And even if I was not a fan of Thy Art is Murder from the very beginning, even if technically I jumped on during the Dear Desolation cycle with songs like Slaves Beyond Death, I can still understand and appreciate what Thy Art is Murder has brought to the table and how they've inspired Curb Stomp the Predator. And for those of you who are wondering, no, I have not listened to Godlike, and there's ultimately a chance that I won't. Just because I don't have the time and I don't really care to listen to it. I think the album cover is actually one of the worst of the year, but that's besides the point. That was a whole lot in one go. So vocally, I will also give this rating a 10 out of 10, just because Josh, he, even back in 2018, had such a, like, raw, like, kind of just, like, that was kind of the prominent sound. And just making sure to give it like howls and stuff. That's really what made this album, I think, what it is vocally speaking. Now, being that Josh is also the instrumentalist, he's also the sound engineer. Like, literally, Josh is Curb Stomp the Predator. If the deathcore scene had something that you could compare to Beartooth as far as the capabilities and the involvement in the creative process, I would definitely say Curb Stomp the Predator is one of those major endeavors, and I really hope to see Curb Stomp the Predator, Josh, or Kirby the Clown, and affiliates take to the stage live for the first time, opening for other major Orange County acts, or even California acts. I think that'd be really cool to hear about in the near future. But, John, erratically, that coincides with the vocal rating, as most of this album has a very Thy Art is Murder-esque deathcore vibe to it, for me. And with the other musical inspirations that Josh mentioned, that being My Children, My Bride, that being, let's see, what's another one? I'm trying to think of a Christian deathcore band that was really popular during the MySpace era. And even just like Christian metalcore bands during the MySpace era. I know Rose Funeral is not one of them, but they are a big one. I remember Josh mentioning Rose Funeral, so that's one. But My Children, My Bride, Rose Funeral, I know it's at the tip of my tongue. Shit, I'll have to figure that out later. And I'll probably add in a little clip, like, somewhere right here. But with all the John Erratic inspirations going on here, this 2018 album is fresh as hell. It is mint as hell, John Erratically speaking, as far as the sound engineering and everything else that Josh did for it when he wasn't doing the vocals for it, simply because it brings back those OG vibes that I missed out on. So I'll definitely give the musical rating, the instrumental rating, a 10 out of 10 as well. Now, let's go ahead and talk about the album cover. So, of course, you know, we'll probably have to provide an explicit warning disclaimer at the beginning of this video, but I have no intention of censoring this. After all, it is a pedophile. It is a predator who's getting this type of treatment after victimizing a poor woman on the left here. And I'm all about how colorful this album cover is while it's also really gory. And just like I said in Session People, I am hoping that in the near future, slam and deathcore kind of migrate into a trend to where everybody that is getting absolutely annihilated on the album covers of all the major bands and their releases, I'm really hoping that we start a trend of labeling every single one of those people that are getting just absolutely annihilated. I hope, as maybe as unrealistic as it would be, because monsters would slaughter without prejudice. They wouldn't, like, dude, imagine if half of those just had like a predator or rapist label on them. That would make things so much better. And I did have an idea that I was meaning to share with Josh the other day. Josh, hi. Hopefully you end up seeing this. I think if you ever want to do AMVs in the future, in the near future, and I'll probably message you about this too, but utilize footage from Goblin Slayer, because no context needed for those who know, but you can absolutely and should totally use clips of goblins getting annihilated as AMVs for your songs in the near future. I think that could be really funny, and it could work really well. But that would be the album cover rating, which I would give an absolute 10 out of 10, because it's nice and colorful, it's simple, it's formula friendly, and it's gory for the right reasons. My overall thoughts for this record: I am ashamed that I did not happen to run across this album when I did, simply because I am definitely all about killing your local rapist, especially when they have done the act and have fed into their minds on multiple occasions. I think it's just fucked up in general. And if it was up to me, I would never want to become a law enforcer, but I would love to become a pedophile hunter. I would love to hunt them down like feeble prey. I would love to hunt them down like the animals that they are, corral them up, and then either jail them or put them on the death chair. That's just me. The electric chair, I mean, not the death chair. I guess it is a death chair, but you get what I mean. So this is Ben Sean Cross doing another Phantom Bird session, this time for Curb Stomp the Predator and their new album, The Father. If you haven't listened to it yet, The Anatomy Crosscast, episode 64, featuring Josh from Curb Stomp the Predator, is now live over on The Anatomy Crosscast. It will be available on the YouTube channel here pretty soon, as this session will be edited into that podcast session. But just like the Great Eternal Music Machine, people, let's keep cranking.